All right, guys, the new stats are out for May 2022. We're going to go over those right now to see what's going on in our real estate market. Are prices going up? Are they going down? Are we heading into a balanced market? Are we crashing down to the ground? That's what we're going to find out in this video right now. Let's have a look. All right, guys, so like always, we take a look at the real estate stats month over month to see what's going on in our marketplace. This is mainly for clients who are looking for more information or just the general public here in the GTA trying to figure out what's going on in our real estate market at the moment. We have the lowdown for you guys, and we have all the information, and we have all the little details that you probably don't hear in other places. We're obviously feet on the ground here. We have active buyers and we have active sellers, so we know exactly what's going on in the marketplace even before you see it in the headlines and before you see the news articles and reports that come out every single day. Now, first and foremost, we just wanted to talk a little bit about our market trends. We're going to talk about kind of historically how we've gotten to where we are right now. We're going to take a look at some charts. We're going to take a look at some numbers to really figure that out. First and foremost, I'm going to bring up this chart that I really like to show. Give me a sec here while I bring it up. Here it is here. So what I wanted to kind of show you guys is how we've gotten here. So I'm going to start in 2020. You can see in my mouse where we're at, right over here. This is the beginning of 2020. The reason I'm starting here is because we were actually about to have such a strong year. That was a year where supposedly we were going to have increased interest rates because we had 2% rates in 2019, 2.5% rates, and they were going to increase a little bit. But right at January, February, we had a really nice pop. You can see this here, that where the trajectory was going. We had a really strong January and February, and halfway through March, actually pretty strong as well. But then COVID hit, and you can see instantly we had our activity and our price point pretty much depleted around this time. What ended up happening after that is that it kind of recovered a bit as we had a little bit more clarity on what COVID was. We ended up like plateauing basically towards the end of the year, where there was still a lot of uncertainty. We still didn't know exactly what was going on. But then what ended up happening is that vaccines kind of came into play. We had a way better understanding in terms of what COVID was, and we kind of started having a, not just for real estate here in the GTA, but kind of globally, we had a resurgence in our marketplace. That was including stocks. If anybody was in the stock market around this time, you know that there was a huge increase towards 2021, and this is what we're seeing here as well. We had kind of a huge jump right at the beginning of the year in 2021, and it was a little bit more of a normal year, in the sense that we had a pretty strong spring, and we actually slowed down a bit in the summertime, because if you recall, in 2021, the summer was a little bit more normal. People were going out a bit more, and they were able to kind of travel a bit as well, and they were going to cottages. There was definitely an uptick in cottage purchases, and that's kind of what was happening. And then we kind of had a little bit of a lull in the summertime. We went back into the fall. We had a pretty strong fall, and what ended up happening is that we had a pretty strong end of year, a little bit stronger than what probably we would have imagined. And this is kind of what we're experiencing recently. Obviously, the growth here in 2021 was just being more comfortable with COVID, and at the same time, it was coupled by very low interest rates, the lowest that we've seen in such a long time. So typically, we do have strong spring and a slower summer, but in 2021, it was the interest rate that really drove a lot of buying. Obviously, our purchasing power was super strong, and it is what it is. Like buyers and the general public tend to follow each other, and when you see a lot of buyers rushing into the marketplace, this is what ends up happening. We had a nice big uptick towards the end of last year and into the beginning of this year, and this is where we started kind of seeing that inflation was a little bit more obvious. Our gas prices started going up. Really, we had a toll on us. We've taken a toll on us every single day in our spending, and then the government really stepped back in, because if you recall, in 2020 they lowered rates to the lowest rates ever because they wanted to conjure spending and economic activity. Now we've had a little bit too much of that. We had a little bit more inflation, and what ended up happening is that we started interest rates climbing at the beginning of this year, and it's still happening to this day. And that interest rate increase has definitely hampered our purchasing power, and we're seeing month over month decline in price points. But we're actually just heading back into this trend line where we're supposed to be at the moment, and that's the interesting thing that we're going to have to see over these next few months. Are we going to continue in this path, and has the little correction that was probably needed, has that already happened? And is this And we're going to have to see really in these coming months how this is going to impact our marketplace. Obviously, having a little bit more interest rate increases throughout this year could trigger a bigger impact in our pricing and our real estate activity as well. So I wanted to kind of start off by showing you that. Come back to me here, just because I think it's important for you to really see kind of a bird's eye view of what the marketplace was over these last few months and years. It's nice to kind of see it in this dotted graph because you kind of see the waves of the real estate cycles and how things kind of play out. So that's very important. So hopefully that gives you a bit more perspective. Now we're going to jump into the monthly stats. The monthly stats is where we're going to kind of start. It's month over month changes, and then we're going to take a look at year over year. Here it is. So let's take a look at our month-to-month stats, guys. We see here that we do have a trend of decreases month over month from April to May. So we're looking at this box over here. Okay, this is actually from the previous month. From March to April, we had some decreases as well, but we're looking from April to May, we've had some decline in our price points for detached homes, for semis, for townhomes. So let's take a look at the difference between last month and this month. We have about a 5%, just under 5% drop in average price for detached homes. Went from, you know, 1.6 to about 1.5. We've also had a semi-detached decline here of about the same, 4.32. We're at 4.14 in townhomes and about 2.4% in condos. Really the detached home and semi-detached home, which is a low-rise property, that was the most popular thing. Everyone was looking for those over the last couple of years. Those are where we're seeing having the biggest impact month over month. In fact, we're actually closer to about 15% from February, which we've now identified to be kind of like peak pricing. We're down about 15% from that point. And we're actually just kind of in a price point where I think that we actually should be closer to. So we're getting back into like a more stable price point, a more reasonable price point for sure. I'll scroll back up here just to kind of see how we got here. In February, detached homes were just under $1.8 million as an average price point in the GTA. This is covering obviously a large geographical area. This is Toronto, this is Durham, this is York region, this is Peel, this is Halton, and we even have Simcoe County as well included in these numbers. So it's definitely a big geographical area, but I would say that we're really elevated here in our price point in February. And so the biggest drop really was from February to March, where we saw that detached homes went down about 5%. If I kind of add all these up here, I'll tell you exactly what number. You won't see it on the screen, but it's about a drop of 14.46%. If I look at semi-detaches here, let's see, let's capture these numbers real quick for you guys. We see a drop of about 11.75%. Townhomes, we are at a 13.45% decrease. And you know, condos were actually the more stable product. The reason is because it's the lowest price point. We see the price disparity here, the difference between, you know, what you can get a condo for compared to a detached home is very drastically different. When I see that, we tend to always really kind of get back closer to a pricing where it's a little bit closer together. And for condos, see here, we were basically down about 3.64% from February, which is really not that big of a difference. So they've kind of held in their price point, but I do see that sales volume for condos has also decreased, and we're seeing people kind of staying on the sidelines. Buyers, what I'm saying, are kind of staying on the sidelines for at all different housing types. This is kind of what we're seeing. However, I think that condos are probably still one of the top property types that are still well priced, and something that you should kind of look out for. Really, in my opinion, now that we've had these few little drops, I think as a buy from a buyer perspective, we're probably in a much better place right now to kind of take a look at take a look at some options and try to lock in a rate, especially if interest rates are continuing to be going up over this next couple months, which it is possible. Yeah, so this is kind of what we're seeing. A month over month change really is showing us kind of a trend in a micro sense. We're not really seeing you know, the price difference between now and last year. That's what I'm actually gonna flip to right now. You're gonna see that the average price point month over month is a little bit different. So let's take a look at specifically the month of May. Switch over. If you see here, we're comparing May May 2022 to May 2021. We see that we do have a drop in sales volume, but that is to be expected. 2021 was a record year. We had the most sales ever in the Toronto Real Estate Board. So, you know, it's really tough to have records year over year. Around 8,000, 7,000 to 8,000 sales per month is pretty normal. And I would say that this is more normal number compared to having almost 12,000 sales at the same time last year. We do see though that our price point is still higher than what we had it last year at 9.4%. So technically speaking, if we compare to last year, we're still at a higher price despite the month over month drops that we've been seeing from the beginning of the year. I would say that we were really elevated at the beginning of the year, and some of the numbers that I was seeing were pretty ridiculous. Definitely wasn't advising some of my clients to put the numbers that I was seeing. And for that reason, you know, I'm not so surprised that we've had like a decline since the last few months. Let's take a look at some of these other numbers. We have an increase in active listings, so there's definitely more inventory out there, more selection for buyers. This is why we're seeing, you know, less bidding wars. However, they're not completely gone. Nice properties still have multiple offers. This is what we're kind of seeing now. And we're also seeing as well that average days on the market are about the same. You know, we have 12 days on the market for most properties. And the difference between listing days on the market and property days on the market. Property days on the market takes into consideration properties that came off the market and went back on with a new price. So you're seeing that it is definitely a little bit higher at about 18 days on the market for most properties. Properties that, you know, don't end up selling on the first go. We are seeing an uptick in that. So not all properties are selling on their offer date, for example. We're seeing them kind of like get delisted and maybe relisted at a higher price point. This is what this is indicating here. Still, I would say that that's pretty low. You know, we're not on the market here for over a month. Still, properties are selling, and I'm still seeing us capture a pretty good price. Okay, so I'm gonna show you another chart here to kind of give you an idea of first sales, just to kind of prove the point that, let's see, just put this up here. We had a really elevated 2021, the same time, the month of May in 2020, we had about 27,000 sales up to that point. And you see the other months as well, you know, we're in that 27 to kind of 35 range, which is pretty normal. This year we're at 40, so we are significantly lower than 2021, the record year, but again, a lot more closer to kind of where we should be at this point in time throughout this year, okay? That's one thing that I want to show you. And also another stat that you want to kind of compare is up to this point, up to May 2022, we're up 18% compared to Jan to May 2021. Okay, so we're still kind of higher there as well. So that's very interesting to note. Another thing that I wanted to kind of show you guys here is where we are in our pricing compared to the last few months, kind of to give you a different view. So if we compare it to January 2022 at 1.24, this is overall GTA price, including all property types. We're about 1.21 at the moment. So just slightly under the pricing that we had in January, significantly under the price that we had in February. We're actually about 9.3% from the peak of February. So there's been a kind of a 9.3% decrease in price point. From February 2022, this is incorporating all property types in all of the GTA. But if I scroll back a bit, you know, what is 1.21 close to? It's kind of closer to December rates, you know, close to like October, November, December of last year. Still, we're selling at a higher price point than fall of last year. And this is kind of a message for my sellers, you know, timing is really everything. We can't predict exactly what's going to happen in our marketplace exactly, but we only really see the history once it's all said and done. And obviously, if you were on the market in the month of February and March, this is when you would have captured the highest price point for your sale. And we're not really seeing those numbers now. This is just the reality. And the activity is lower. There's more listing competition and there's less buyers in the marketplace. So all those things kind of coupled together means that you got to be a little bit more careful with your listing strategy, and you gotta definitely put a lot more effort as well. So as I scroll back here though, I just kind of want to show you that even if I go back to May 2021, you know, we were still at that 1.1 price point as an average price in the GTA. And so here, you know, about $100,000 more 1 year later, we're still significantly higher. And so this is why I say that from a seller perspective, you can still capture a pretty good number. Okay, so those are the stats, guys. So hopefully that gives you a nice perspective in terms of what to expect in our marketplace. I think that, you know, what we're seeing here is warranted. I think we're pretty elevated at the beginning of the year. So I'm definitely not surprised that we have a lower price today in May than we did earlier this year. And I'm also not surprised that we're not too far off from pricing that we were seeing in fall of last year. I'm also not surprised that we have a drop in sales because interest rates do impact buyer behavior, and we do see that interest rates have gone up. Now that was a great tour. Now if you like that video and the information provided, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out on future content. Also make sure you hit the thumbs up button so this video gets shared to others. Now if you're interested in more GTA tours, you're going to want to click on this video right over here. And if you want to get more information on GTA neighborhoods, you're going to want to click on this video right over here. Thanks again, guys, and see you in the next one.